So why was it that you didn't want us to memorize them?
So I said don't memorize them because I'm not going to put them on a midterm or a final. Mm-hmm. Though they could be useful in your homeworks, which is why they're in a box. But I'm just saying don't put them on your formula page because I won't ask you questions that have these directly in them.
Right. But they're good to know.
They're good to know, good practice. They'll be on some homeworks. But I think there's enough for you to worry about on your formula page that you don't need to put all the hyperbolic stuff on there.
Ones like they're on my net too, huh?
So if they're on your formula page, I would just erase them when you need space. Don't bother erasing them until you need space. All right, so here's our first example. Oh, did I not write down the inverse, the antiderivatives? I don't think I wrote down the antiderivatives.
No, you didn't.
Okay. So first of all, which of these forms are we going to be using? You're looking at the right column.
Tangent inverse.
So I don't think it'll be tangent inverse because that's the only one, or that's one of the two without a square root. So that's out.
Oh, I didn't see the square root.
So what, and it's not going to be secant or cosecant, because those have that extra x hanging around, which we don't have. So it's pretty much, oh no, I better change it. 3 plus 4x squared. All right.
Now it'll be sine.
All right, we have an issue though. So I'm going to write down the antiderivative form for hyperbolic sine. So we have 1 over square root 1 plus u squared du equals sine hyperbolic inverse u plus c. So we're going to use this right here. Now, normally I would say use the one with an a in it, but I don't know that one off the top of my head, so I'm not going to just write it down. I might skip a, you know, maybe the u should be divided by a. So I don't want to just change it around here. What we're going to do instead is turn 3 plus 4x squared into 1 plus u squared. So it looks like u probably should equal 2x in this case. However, let's get the 3 out of here first. So how do I move that 3 out? So I'm going to factor it. So we're factoring that 3 out. So any questions on that factoring right there? I want to turn this number into a 1 to get into that form.
Okay.
Now, of course, by doing that, I'm complicating the x squared term. But that's OK. We will overcome that. So this is 1 over square root 3 integral dx over square root. Now I'm going to write 4 thirds x squared. As 4 thirds square root squared. So I can write it like this. So we really have 2 over square root 3x whole thing squared. So I applied a square root squared and then simplified it down. All right, so this is in the right form. Go ahead and make your u substitution and find the antiderivative. And we got the hyperbolic sine form at the top of the board right there you can use. So there should be a straightforward u sub, nothing tricky going on from here.